The Little Mermaid, retold from the original by Hans Christian Andersen. Once upon a time there was a kingdom that was set right at the bottom of the sea. There was no bare layer of white sand here. In this kingdom you couldn't even see the seabed, for it was covered with plants in incredible shapes and rocks in all colours. In the deepest part of this spectacular kingdom was set the palace of the Merking. The Merking had been a widower for many years, so his mother kept the palace spick and span for him. Nobody could fault her for the care she took of her grandchildren, the little princesses. They were six lovely mermaids, and the youngest one was the most beautiful. She also had the sweetest voice, and the Merking loved her to serenade him. All the little mermaids were allowed to swim around the palace gardens all day, and they made a lovely sight as they swam gracefully with the fish and other creatures of the deep. Their grandmother would spend many hours telling the mermaids tales of the towns, humans, and animals that lived on the land above. The youngest mermaid loved her grandmother's tales, but she always thought that they were far too fantastic to be true. When you are 15, you will be able to swim to the surface, and you will see for yourself that all my tales are absolutely true, her grandmother told her. Once the little mermaid heard this, she spent many quiet moments gazing up through the deep blue water, longing for the day when she could go to the surface. Whenever she saw her older sisters swimming to the top, she felt very envious. How I wish I was 15, she would sigh impatiently. At last her 15th birthday came, and everyone in the Sea Kingdom celebrated by giving her a spectacular party. Farewell, her sisters cried as they watched her rise up through the water. The sun had just set when she lifted her head above the surface. She had picked a calm, still evening for her first trip. When the little mermaid rose to the surface of the water, she looked around in wonder. A few yards away, she could see a three-masted ship standing motionless on the calm sea. The little mermaid swam close to a porthole and peeped inside. A party was going on. The cabin was full of well-dressed, happy people. The most handsome was a young prince who had large dark eyes that sparkled as he laughed. It was his birthday party. The ship's crew danced on deck, and the young prince came up to watch them, and as they danced, hundreds of fireworks could be seen in the sky. Showers of glittering rain and shining suns whizzed through the air. The little mermaid had never seen anything like this before. Eventually, as it grew late and the party ended, the guests retired to their cabins. The little mermaid was about to return to the kingdom of the Merking when she noticed huge waves gathering around the ship. A storm was brewing up, a huge black storm. Soon the waves grew so high that the little mermaid could barely see the ship behind them. A bolt of lightning struck the ship, and within minutes it had sunk beneath the waves. At first the little mermaid was delighted. "Now he will come down to me," she said. But then she remembered that men cannot live in the sea, and she realized that the prince would be dead before he got to her father's palace. The prince must not die, she thought, so she dived straight into the wreckage to look for him. After searching for some time, she found him struggling to get away from the wreck. The little mermaid held his head above water and let the waves carry them along. On and on she swam until at last, when dawn was breaking, they came to an island. A group of young girls were out walking on the island, so the little mermaid left the prince in a place where they would find him, then swam out to some rocks and hid behind them. It wasn't long before one of the young girls saw the prince. The prince opened his eyes and smiled at the beautiful girl who stood above him. He had completely forgotten that the little mermaid was nearby and that it was she who saved him. As the little mermaid hadn't been noticed, she dived down into the sea and swam sadly home to her father's palace. For many months afterwards, the little mermaid wept for her handsome prince. She knew that her only hope of finding him again was to seek the advice of the sea witch. So off she swam to the sea witch's cold, strange kingdom.
"I know what you want,"
cackled the old sea witch when she saw the little mermaid swimming towards her. You want to get rid of your fish tail and have two legs, so that the prince will fall in love with you. All right, I will mix you a potion to help you lose your fish tail, but you must drink it tomorrow before sunrise. The little mermaid was excited at the thought of having a pair of legs, because she knew that if she could make the prince fall in love with her, she would gain an immortal soul and would never die. The sea witch was just about to hand over the potion when she made one request. I always want payment for my work, she said. So in return for your pretty legs, you must give me your beautiful voice. So be it, said the little mermaid, as she knew she had no choice in the matter. Then the sea witch uttered some magic words, and a few moments later the little mermaid found herself sitting at the bottom of the marble steps at the prince's castle. While the moon was still up, she drank the potion, and it felt as if a sword was going through her body. She fainted and lay on the floor as if she were dead. The prince, who was taking his early morning walk, saw the beautiful girl lying at the foot of the stairs. By now her fish's tail had disappeared, and she had a pair of legs just like any other human. He tapped her gently on the shoulder and spoke kind words to her. "Who are you, and where have you come from?" he said. She looked at him with sad eyes, but she could not speak because the sea witch had already taken her voice. He took the beautiful, silent girl by the hand and led her up to his castle. Every single step she took felt like sharp knives were digging into her legs, but she was willing to suffer for love, and she walked gracefully beside the prince. When she reached the castle, she was given fine clothes of silk and velvet to put on and introduced to the rest of the court. Amazed at her beauty, everyone wanted to know where she came from, but she couldn't answer any of the questions they asked. The day of her arrival was a special day of feasting, and beautiful girls sang to the prince and the king. One sang more beautifully than the rest, and the prince clapped his hands and smiled sweetly at her when she had finished. This made the little mermaid very sad, for she knew that she once had had a far sweeter voice. She thought to herself, "If only the prince knew that to be with him I have given my sweet voice away for ever." But one thing that the little mermaid could now do was dance. On hearing the beautiful music, she lifted her hands and rose on the tips of her toes. She danced very gracefully, but every time she danced, she felt as if she had stepped on a knife. That night, when she retired to bed, she wept, because all she could think of was her sisters, who were in the kingdom under the sea. The next night, the little mermaid was lying in her bed in the castle when she heard a sad murmuring sound coming from beneath her bedroom window. She rushed outside, and there were all her mermaid sisters sitting on a rock. "You have caused us much sorrow," her eldest sister told her. "Your father has become ill with grief since you left his kingdom and joined the human race. Why don't you come back home with us? The kingdom of the Mer-King is where you belong." These harsh words made the little mermaid very sad indeed. She desperately wanted to tell her sisters that she loved the prince and had become a human for his sake, but the words just wouldn't come out. "Oh, how I wish I could tell my sisters that this is my only way of winning the love of a prince and gaining an immortal soul," she thought to herself. But her sisters grew angry with her silent manner and swam back down to their father's sea kingdom. Rumour soon spread around the palace that the king had chosen Princess Marina from the neighbouring kingdom as a bride for the prince. The rumours upset the little mermaid. "Oh, if only the prince would remember that it was I who saved his life. Then he would love me," she thought. One day the prince told the little mermaid, "I have to go on a special journey to see Princess Marina, who lives in the next kingdom. It's my parents' wish that I marry her, but they won't force me to bring her home as my bride. If I ever choose a bride, it shall be you, even though you cannot speak a word." So the prince set off to meet Princess Marina. As soon as he saw her, he recognized her face straight away. "You are the girl who saved my life on the island," he said joyfully. So the wedding was arranged for the next day, and although Princess Marina was his first love, The prince still had a special place in his heart for the little mermaid, and she was the guest of honour. The little mermaid stood in the church holding the bride's train, but all her thoughts were on what she had lost in this world. That night the bride and bridegroom went on board their ship to begin their honeymoon. The little mermaid accompanied them on their journey, but she grew so restless that she took a stroll on deck. As she looked out to sea, she saw her mermaid sisters swimming towards her once again. The elder sister looked up and said, "We have given our hair to the sea witch, so you will not have to die tonight. Look, here is the knife that the witch has given to us. Before sunrise, you must plunge it into the prince's heart. When you have done this, your legs will turn into a fishtail, and you will be a mermaid again. But hurry, after sunrise it will be too late, and you will die." Her hand shaking, the little mermaid took the knife and watched her sisters disappear beneath the waves. Then she returned to the cabin, where the prince was sleeping with his new bride. But she knew that she could not harm him, so she threw the knife onto the floor and rushed back on deck. On deck, she dived into the still waters. She seemed to fly through the air, and she felt no pain as she touched the waves. She looked up at the sun and saw hundreds of lovely creatures hovering above her. Their voices were beautiful and melodic, and when she tried to speak, she found that she had a voice just like them. Suddenly, she felt herself being lifted up into the clouds. She could hear the soft, gentle voices whispering all around her. "Where am I?" she said in a voice just like the others. "We are princesses of the sky," they answered. "Come with us and you can earn an eternal soul by doing good deeds for all the world." The little mermaid looked down and saw that the prince and princess were searching for her, but by now she was invisible to them. This made her so sad that a little tear fell down her cheek. But as her fellow princesses were calling her, she floated with them through the air, and they went on their way spreading love and happiness throughout the world. The end.